Good morning. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Please stand. Please stand. A little cold this morning, but we get to come in and warm up when the Lord and worship Him. And just raise your hands and start to give it all to God today, you know. And then if there's any visitors today, I believe that God has got something in store for you this morning. You don't have to walk like you came when all those worries and problems are there around the world. Today, ask the Lord to renew your mind and straighten you. And He will do it because He's a good God. We serve an awesome God in this. And today, I'm going to read a scripture. And be not conformed by this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye might prove that is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. And in Romans chapter 12 and verse 2. Let's pray and start this service in the name of Jesus. All right, let's pray. Lord God, we thank you. We love you, Lord Jesus, for this beautiful opportunity you've given us today, Lord God. Lord God, we can never thank you enough, Lord God, because we truly know that you are so faithful, Lord God. Lord God, we ask you, Lord God, this morning to touch our brothers that they might not feeling good today. It is healing that needs to be in some of our family members, Lord God. Lord Jesus, we pray over this service, Lord God, that you put your hands on everyone in this room, Lord Jesus. Lord God, we love you, and we know that you're already in the situation, Lord God. Lord God, we pray for these worshipers in this morning, Lord God. Let us not worry. Let us worship you, Lord God, with all our hearts and our minds, Lord God. We pray in the name of Jesus, Lord God. In Jesus' name, amen. Watch him as they sing. Jesus.
Right now, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for loving us, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We thank you, God. There's a sweet presence of God in here this morning. Young people, you are dismissed to your classes. This morning, we are going to Ephesians 1 and 7, 1 Peter 1 and 19. In whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the richness of his grace. 1 Peter 1 and 19. But with the precious blood of Christ, as a lamb without blemish and without spot. Pastor, will you pray? You may be seated. For a little bit, I want to preach on the title, The Power of the Blood Still Works. So, I'll tell you one of my bad habits. One of my bad habits is I scratch my arms and I pick scabs. And I get in trouble for it all the time. And I'm just being honest with you. But I'm going somewhere with this. That's why I'm telling you this. So, I get blood on my shirt. And I get in trouble. Not in trouble, but I get told. So, that stain is hard to get out sometimes. The stain is hard to get out, and sometimes it don't come out, sometimes it does come out. But that blood stain, if you ever watch a forensic show, it stays there for a while. Because they can take a bright light and see that stain. God's blood does the same thing to our lives. When he was getting beaten and he was getting spit on, when he's walking up the hill of Calvary, every ounce of blood he shed going up to the hill, then when he got hung on the cross and the blood shed. All the attributes of Jesus throughout his life, all the forgiveness, all the love, everything that he did on the earth came out that day through the blood. Because Jesus is the only man I know. And if you're a perfect man, you can stand up. Because Jesus is the only perfect man I know. He's the man that has forgave. He's the man that has rose. The dead has rose because he called them out like he did Lazarus. Amen. Hebrews 9 and 12. Neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood, he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. For if the blood of bulls and of goats and the ashes of heifers sprinkling the unclean sanctified to purifying of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? My friend, I want you to realize today, you're going to have a stain on your life. You're going to have a stain on your life, and that stain is going to be Jesus Christ. And I want you to realize today, whatever you're going through, it's the blood of Christ that's going to give the forgiveness. That's going to wash it white as snow, my friend. My friend, it's going to make you straighten up, because when God died on the cross for us, he forgave all sin, all mess up. He forgave everything. My friend, I don't care what you're going through today. I don't care if you're struggling with something today. It's covered by the blood. My friend, that's why we go down in the name of Jesus. Because that's a symbolization of his blood. That's just not water, my friend. That you're going down in the blood of Jesus. When you come up, you're white as snow, my friend. My friend, my God's already put a stain on you if you went down in the name of Jesus. My friend, my God has already delivered you out because you went down in the name of Jesus. What am I telling you today? I don't care what you're going through, honey, today. My God has your back. My God has it. He has you, and he's taking care of you, and he's still taking care of you today. I don't care what you're going through today. It's all right if you got a stain on your life. It's a stain of Jesus. It's a stain of Jesus. It's going to be okay. He understands the hard trials. He walked up Calvary. He got spit on. He got beat. He understands hard times. He went through that so he could cover, the blood could cover all the sins. He showed us our attitudes. Beatitudes in Matthew. He showed us how to walk on the face of the earth with love and forgiveness. His blood was full of that, my friend. His blood covers all, my friend. My friend, you cannot forget about the blood of Jesus. I know it's not Easter, honey, but my friend, we have to be reminded that the stain of God that he's leaving on our life is a forever blood. My friend, I don't care what's going on in your life. He has you covered. He has you covered. He has it. Matthew 26 and 28. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remissions of sins. Remissions, my friend. I'm telling you today, I don't care what you're going through. There's no sin too big that my God can't cover. My God has you. He's always had you. No matter the problem you're going through today, he has you. He has your back. He's always had your back. My God is wanting to put the stain on your life and say, hey, it's going to be okay. You just got to trust me. You just have to trust me, because I know God knows what he's doing in your life. Sometimes as humans, we like to do things ourselves. It don't work out too well. Revelations 1 and 5. And from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, and the first begotten of the dead, and the prince of kings of the earth, unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood. No matter what you're going through, my friend, no matter how fearful you are today of what's going on in the world today, he has you. He's going to wash it out with his own blood, and it's going to be okay. It's going to be okay. The blood covers corona. The blood covers everything on the earth today. My friend, the oceans are moving because my God's blood got in the oceans. My friend, the ground is able to be tilled because my God's blood is in the ground. My friend, this earth's moving on its axis because my God's blood has been spilled. My friend, my God's blood is covering your life today, and he has your back. My friend, ladies and gentlemen, my God has your back, and he's wanting to do something for you today. He's wanting to create a miracle in you today. There ain't no sickness, no disease too big for God. First John 1 and 7. But if we walk in light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanseth us from all sin. He cleans us from all sin. I don't care what you're going through today. He has you. He has you covered. Stop fighting with depression. Stop fighting with the battle of the mind, because my God has you. He has always had you. When you went down in the name of Jesus, guess what? You left everything there. And the blood has conformed to your body, trying to make you understand that you got to live for Christ. The only reason we mess up, it's because we get away from the blood. Because we don't want clean anymore. We don't want that stain on our life. We got to have everything perfect in our life. But the only thing perfect that you ever have in your life is Jesus Christ. The blood still works. The blood still forgives. The blood still cleans sin, my friend. The blood still purifies. The blood will still wash you white as snow. There ain't nothing in your life the blood can't cover. There's still power in the blood. When I'm going through a hard time, I plead the blood. Because I can't get away from the blood. That's why, Brother Kent, that's why I got to die daily, every day. Just not when I get baptized in Jesus' name and it washes my sins away. It goes every day. I'm human just like you are. I have to ask for forgiveness every day because I gotta strive to be perfect because I gotta match the blood. I have to walk. I have to try to walk like my Jesus walked. I might fail, but guess what? When I fail, I'm gonna get back up and start searching after the blood of Jesus again. My friend, I don't care what you're going through.
Get back up and start marching toward Jesus again. Marching towards where the forgiveness is again. Marching where the peace is again. Marching in where the joy is again. Marching where we praise Him again. My friend, keep on marching on, my friend. My God is wanting you to serve Him with all your heart. Anything you're going through today, He has your back. Anything you're going through today, it's covered by the blood. My friend, my God has you. It's the blood. It's the blood that covers everything. I don't care how dirty you get, my friend. I don't care if you went out and drunk last night. It still covers you. It covers you. You might have messed up last night, but guess what? It's going to be okay. Today, you get to the altar. You get in your prayer closet. You ask forgiveness, and you plead the blood over it. And guess what? My God's going to forgive you, my friend. That don't mean you go out and serve the world. That means you just get right back in here and serve Christ like you've always done. My friend, my Jesus and His blood has always forgave. Always. He has always, always covered you and always has gave you what you need. Why doubt Him now in the time of need? Why doubt Him in the time of need that you're going through right now? The blood still covers. The blood still heals. I can't make it without the blood. That's the reason when I went down in the name of Jesus, I was saying, Jesus is going to cover my life the rest of my life. But at that time, listen up, new converts. When you go down in the name of Jesus, you still got work to do. It takes everyday walk. It takes everyday repentance. Just like when you got the Holy Ghost, it takes an everyday repentance saying, hey, I'm sorry. Change me, God. Repentance is just not about being sorry. It's about changing your life. That's what happens when the blood of Jesus gets all over you. You want to change. You want to step away from sin. And you want to get better in Christ. You want to get to know a God that can heal and save and deliver. You want to get to know a God that has walked on the water. You want to get to know a God that has rose the dead. My friend, you want to get to know a God that has brought you out and delivered you out, my friend. And it's all because He shed His blood on Calvary. My God has you covered. The power of the blood still works, my friend. You say, Brother Steve, that that's 2,000 years ago. It's an everlasting stain. My God has you. He has stained your life. Don't try to wash out His stain. The only way you're going to wash His stain out is Him going to make you white as snow. By repentance. When my God bled on the cross and you decided to serve a living God, He stained your life ever since. From the day when my mama dropped me off at a revival service on a Monday night of me receiving the baptism of the Holy Ghost when I was 8 years old. From that day forward, I realized the blood that covered my life. The blood covers your life. When you make that decision, be proud of it.
Grab onto it. Let it stain your life. Let it become you. Let it control you. Let it consume you. Let people realize that the blood of Jesus is all over your life. The blood of Jesus will correct a lot of things in your life. My friend, the blood of Jesus will help you forgive. The blood of Jesus will help you forget. The blood of Jesus will keep your attitude in check. Because, my friend, I promise you, I believe I said it last time I preached. I promise you, you start talking about the name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus. You can't be in a bad mood. I know I can't. Because my mind starts thinking about all the things he's brought me through. Everything that he's done for me, Brother Dustin.
Oh God,
and all the things he's covered in my life with his blood. And how he stained my life. And how powerful he has been. How powerful has he been in your life today? Is he worth serving him for? Has Jesus been so powerful? Is he worth serving? I say yes, my friend. What do you say in your life today? Are you willing to put everything on the line for Jesus like he put everything on the line for you? Are you willing to follow him as close as he has tried to follow you, my friend? My friend, are you willing to have a stain on your life that he wants to put on your life? Are you willing to do what you need to do for God? My God is wanting to know if you're going to step up. He is challenging some of you, saying, hey, I want you to step up for me. He's trying to shake some of you, some of the things that you face right now in your life. You have forgot that the blood has covered you. You face and you keep on moving forward without searching a God that can. Believe that he has you covered. Believe that he has your back. I can take you from scripture to scripture that he has your back and he has you covered. But the only thing missing from taking you from scripture, that you believing that he can do everything in your life. See, the scripture will lead you there. But you got to have the belief that to get there. When you went down in the water, did you go down with the understanding that the blood has covered you? And it has your back. Or did you go down in the water because someone told you? When you go down in the water, you better understand, my friend, you go down in blood. It's a symbolization of blood that covers you. There ain't no water that's going to make you clean like the blood makes you clean. Your life is covered by the blood. Your life is all about the blood of Jesus. I hope this reminder of the blood has helped you today. Because he has you covered. The power of the blood still works today. I don't care if you've been baptized 50 years ago. I don't care if you were baptized last week. You'll always, always need the blood. Because that's the, between God and the blood, that's the only thing that has your back. Family might come against you. Friends might come against you. Your bosses may come against you. But my Jesus has always been for you. His blood has always covered you. He's always covered you every step that you took and every move that you made. My friend, he has your back in the bad times and the good times. And when he's covered you, that he means he's going to heal you, my friend. And that's going to give you the power of forgiveness. To forgive your enemies. To forgive the problems and situation that's going on in your life. When the human side wants to just talk about it and get ugly about it. When God just wants to show love about it and work it out for you peacefully. The decision's yours, my friend. What stain are you going to have on your life? You're going to have a half the stain of the world and God. You're going to just put the whole stain of God on your life. You're going to let the blood of Jesus cover you and correct you like it needs to correct you. The blood of Jesus, when you go down in the name of Jesus, then you receive the Holy Ghost. That's why the Holy Ghost can stay inside of you. It's because of the blood of Jesus that has covered you. It's the blood. And going down in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, it's not the Father, it's not the Son, it's not the Holy Ghost, it's the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, it was Jesus' blood that covered you and you went down. And it's Jesus' blood that's going to cover you through your problems and situation. Can we all stand? I pray today that God is knocking at your door. And you're knocking at his saying, I need you to cover me again. I don't know who I'm talking to. It might not be no one in this room. It might be someone on the internet. But someone needs to hear about the blood today. Amen. Your blood. His blood has your back. Amen. Believe in the word of God. Believe every word, every period, every comma in the word of God. If you believe in the word of God, you're going to see the word of God walk in your life. And you're going to see the blood of Jesus cover your life like you never have before. But you have to believe. You have to believe that he has your back. And he does. I'm going to turn it over to our pastor.
Amen. How many knows that you're covered? Turn to your neighbor and say, I'm covered. Covered by the blood of the Lamb today. Thank you, Brother Steve, for that sermon, that message today. And I'm excited to be covered by the blood. You know, whenever Satan jumps on your back and tries to remind you of what you did, remind him of how God's got that covered by the blood. It's covered by the blood. If I can only add anything to that today, my encouragement to you is if there's sin in your life, get it covered quickly. The Bible says you reap what you sow, but how can you reap something that God has taken away quickly? Let that sit in a little bit. As soon as you can get it covered by the blood, the less chance you have of reaping some things that you know you sow. There's a whole lot of things that all of us have sown that we didn't reap. The reason why you didn't reap it wasn't because you got away with it. It's because there was a higher power that was coming down that was covering the sin that we had in our life as soon as it happens. That's why we need to pray every day. die every single day that you live so you can get some things covered in your life. You can get some things covered in. I'm not talking about just praying real quick, Lord, forgive me real quick, God. I don't want to reap that. I'm talking about turning away from your sin. Turn away from your sin and watch God's blood work for you. Thank you, Brother Steve, for reminding us of the blood of Jesus Christ. How many's thankful for the blood? You know, you wouldn't be here without the blood. You wouldn't be here without the blood of Jesus Christ. So in closing prayer today, we want to remember those that are not feeling well today. We want to remember them in our prayers. Let's continue to remember Brother Isaac, Sister Lindsay, and that beautiful baby girl that was delivered yesterday evening. I was under the impression that they said, well, we're going to try to wait till that 34-week mark, which I think would have been, I think, next Friday or Saturday. And so he said, but you're going to stay here until then. And so we got the text message, hey, this had me put on some scrubs. It's go time. Okay. All right. So I guess the baby's ready. So let's go. But it's very beautiful. So let's pray for them. They've got a little journey here coming up. We want to remember them in our prayers. And Brother Isaac and Sister Lindsay are such a vital part of our church. They literally have their hands in everything. And I'm thankful. I'm thankful that in our church we got another one that just steps up. You know, another one just steps into place. But we want to remember them in our prayers. And they thought they was going to have a baby after Christmas, but sometimes Christmas comes a little early. So we want to continue to remember them in prayer. And again, all those that are sick and afflicted today, that God remember them. Let's remember our children. Our children that are practicing for Christmas program. How many loves Christmas programs? I mean, I love Christmas programs, and they're practicing real hard for that. Let's remember our teachers and all those today. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, I love you. Lord, I thank you today for your many blessings. I thank you, Lord, today that your blood still works and it still covers us. Thank you for reminding us the importance of the blood. Jesus, I pray today, Lord, that you would touch those that are sick and afflicted. Move upon their bodies, that the blood cover them as well. I pray, Jesus, Lord, that you continue to touch Brother Isaac, Sister Lindsay, and that precious baby girl. I pray, Lord, that you continue to move upon our Sunday school children, their teachers, God, those that are working very hard to teach our kids about the word of the Lord. I pray, Lord Jesus, that your blessings flow in our next service, God. We thank you for the blessings that we received in this one, Lord, but bless us again, Lord, the next one, God. And we promise to give you our very best, the praise that you so desire and deserve. We love you. Praise you and give you glory in all things. And the church said, in Jesus' name, amen. You'll be dismissed, and we'll be back here very shortly. May the Lord bless you.
First Corinthians 15:55-57 says, death is swallowed up in victory. I think I'll say it again. Death is swallowed up in victory.